friends of poetry, thank you for the Lee Bennett Hopkins Honor Award for my humble book, Amaze Me. This is Naomi Shihab Nye here, speaking to you from beautiful San Antonio, Texas, the state of Texas where there are still liberal Democrats, many of them, and many independent people as well. I'm so honored to be among you in this way, and I appreciate the committee of judges. Thank you for selecting this book as an honor book this year. Lee Bennett Hopkins, thank you for all you do for poetry. You are our dear friend, and we're all connected through this wonderful genre, which comforts and enlivens our lives. I'd like to thank the illustrator for Amaze Me, Terry Marr. You can remember her name because it's like Bill Maher, my personal TV hero. She lives in Cleveland, Ohio. This is the first book that Terry has ever been part of as an artist illustrator. We met through the mail. We were pen pals. She sent me beautiful little pictures that she made for her daughter's lunch boxes, the size of the little pictures which are on the back of the book, attached to her letters to me. And I fell in love with her artistic style. And when I was writing this book of poems for an audience of girls about the age of 12 or 13 or 11, I kept thinking of Terry's artwork, and I really thought the two things went together. So that's how the art and the words came to be in this book. I feel very lucky to be connected to girls around the age of adolescence, because that age is so important and exquisite and a bit treacherous. And I think I have a good memory of what it was like. And I always feel, when I see girls of that age, that I want to listen to them and ask what they think about, what they're worried about. I hope my book is a friend to them. And I thank you for being a friend to the book. I wanted to read one short poem from the book. There are different topics examined. One of the poems girls tell me they like is, it begins, "Babysitting should not be called sitting." When I was 12, I was very heavily active as a babysitter. There are poems about people and places and personal crushes and concerns about getting older. All various topics that I remember vividly thinking about at the age of 12 myself. I was the only person among my group of friends who did not want to get any older. So far, what I can say about getting older is you can still be 12, and no one else knows that, but you always are. This poem is called "Sometimes I Pretend," and I dedicate it to all of you who do so many things in your lives for readers, for children, for people who care about the word. Sometimes I pretend I'm not me. I only work for me. This feels like a secret motor churring inside my pocket. I think she will be so glad when she sees the homework neatly written. She will be relieved. Someone sharpened pencils, folded clothes. To you, to poetry, to Lee Bennett Hopkins, thank you very much.